That's 15 pins. So from the 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 to that one there. So we are good there. Everything's pushed down good. Yep. All right, let's get these caps on. Get these torqued down. These need to be scuffed up a little bit and cleaned off. They're a little hard to get in there. Take some Scotch-Brite pad and kind of clean them up. Sometimes I just don't want to go on easy. Alright, there's two. There's a couple more in here. One over there. One more. So just the three. There should be one more. Cap. Oh yeah, there it is. Last one's gonna go on this side. Got a little lube on those. A little drip. Can't hurt nothing. Alright, so I got the intake here. It's gonna go here. And I just use a rubber mallet, dead blow hammer, to kind of get those to seat. See if I can reach one. Exhaust. Make sure it's all the way down, guys, because if you tighten them down, you may crack something, break something. No sense in doing that. And then this will go in here. And then I'll just run these into the impact, not all the way, just to get them down further. That way, it's not such a pain to try to ratchet them all the way down, I guess you could say. Torque them all the way down that low. Size of this there. Alright, so these are going to go get tightened down to, I think we got to do it in intervals. Alright, so the cam caps get tightened down to 89 inch pounds, but it says do it in several passes, so I'm going to start with like 20. It says doing a crisscross pattern. Make sure we got them all 20. Looks like it. And then we'll go up to 30.
I'll go up to 35.
Not really much noticeable difference, but I'm sure we could go up to 30 if we had to. We're at 50. Well, that's 35. Let's just go ahead and go up to 40. And we'll go up to 50. And we'll go up to 70. And we'll go up to 89. All right, that is that. So I think while I'm at this point, I'm gonna go ahead and check the valve clearances, because let me put the tensioner in first. That way it's all buttoned up. That way if we need to just go ahead and ship it, we'll go ahead and put it back together, so. We'll go ahead and back this bolt out and it's always the one I don't have out. And they're so tight. There it goes. I'm gonna reset the spring here. So in order to reset these, just go ahead and pop this little tab down. And then just push that back in. I'm gonna lube this all up before I stick it in there. Alright, so there should be a new gasket for that in this kit, which there is. And then I have to find the bolts for that. It should be in here somewhere.
You can see these things. I've had two of these now. I've had to do this too to get these things off. I didn't cut that. The last guy did. I just chiseled it off to get it off. So I'll order some more of these.
Where are the bolts for the tensioner? That is a good question. It must be in this bin. And they're not. Are they in here? Should be down. Oh, yeah, they are. There's one. Alright, gasket goes on like so. You can't mess this up because it says up on it right there. All right. So
you put the spring back in with for the tensioner. So I'll go ahead and just kind of pull that down a little bit. I mean, I don't think there's really a need to, but you can hear it clicking out. That'll put the tension on the chain there. Go ahead and tighten her up. Snug her down. We'll call that good. I'm going to go ahead and measure the clearances real quick. Find my trusty multi flashlight. We are still at top dead center. So I'll get my gauges out. So intake should be 0.10 to 0.010 to 0.020. All right, everything's in spec. Valves are in the lower end, so exhaust is at 0.20 millimeters and intake is at 0.10 millimeters. So we're right at the bottom. This is the setup from that bike, that the donor bike that I got. So my guess is that one had low hours as well. It doesn't seem very worn. All right, let's get this valve cover on there. Put some RTV just in the half moons there, just to help it seal a little bit better. I do believe they recommend that you do that. Let's see if we can get this I hate this stuff. It always dries up inside the tube there. All right, so I just usually go ahead and squirt some, put some on my finger or a Q-tip. Q-tip's a little easier to manipulate. Let's just do that. I got some out here, so might as well. I don't need a whole lot, but let's do the corner, and then we'll just kind of go down. And I was like, leave a little blob at the corner there. That should take care of it. Same thing with the other side. Gonna get this extra off there. Little blob on the corner. Little blob on that corner. And then just run some down across. Now once you get it on there, you can clean it up. where's the word for this? Go ahead and get our gasket for that. And our valve cover is where? Let's go ahead and use this other one that we got this weekend. So go ahead and use this one. This is the one that came on the donor bike. wipe this off. Any sand, the grit might be in here. And then the gasket will just fall into place like so. Don't need any silicone on this end. I never have put any on this part. So just manipulate it into the cover here. Push her down, get her situated. Just like so. Get my shrink at the middle down there. And then it is definitely easier to do this without that cross member in there, right there, because it'll give you a little more room. So we'll go ahead and just do it without it in there. And just make sure those go down. Do little spots there. And just go ahead and give it a little love tap. And I usually just kind of clean this end, this stuff up here. Get any extras. Clean it off when you're all done if you want to. But I'll just do it while it's wet. Just makes it a little easier. Clean it off. Believe it or not, I'm going to show you guys a little thing I saw in this book here. You got to find it first. It was about the valve cover, and I do believe it said to make sure you tighten the bolts while it is at top dead center. I'm sure many people overlooked that little paragraph, but I noticed it one day. Let me just find it. Right here. So if you read, it says the cylinder head cover is bolted to the camshaft caps. Whenever the cover is removed or installed, set the engine at top dead center. This takes the camshaft pressure off the caps. So you can see that. So make sure you guys, when you put it back together, the cylinder head cover, you do it at top dead center. So let's go ahead and get those on. Missing the rubber.
interesting. That's what I need. It's missing this piece of rubber. And then let's see if they get torqued. So valve cover. I don't see one. I'm probably missing it, but we'll just go ahead and snug these up by hand. Nothing crazy. Just snug them up. Let's see what we got for sizes here. So that is none of them.
Alright guys, look at these valves. This is off the bike, the orange one. This is the original. Like, how does it even get that bad? And this one's got so much deposits right there, it's ridiculous. Let me show the other valves. This is the intake valves. They got these exhaust valves. And these things are pretty. Like, look at all that carbon. My God, it's like. If you guys ever smoke pot, when you got to clean out your bowl at the end of the year, this is what this looks like. This is just ridiculous. Both of them. I mean, this one's even worse. You can see it's all pitted on the edges too. Let me get this to focus. But I mean, it's bad. Ridiculous.